Hello everyone, the aim of this presentation is to discuss an important concept in biology, that is biological species concept. As you know, species is the basic unit of classification and is also considered as the smallest evolutionary unit. In this presentation, I will first highlight the importance of species, then I will mention the historic perspective of species concept, and then I will elaborate biological species concept in detail, and finally I will discuss some of the issues related with biological species concept. Before we discuss the biological species concept, it is important to understand why species are so important. For a biologist, species are important for the taxonomic classification of vast biodiversity. Species are also important for the identification of keystone species and predator species. Elucidation of role of species in ecological functioning and integrity is possible when we understand the basics of particular species. In recent times, the identification of particular species is important for the conservation of vast biodiversity. Historic background of species concept is very important and is also interesting. The idea of species dates back to earliest days of farming. The Greek naturalists, including Aristotle, wrote about the essence of species, though they were knowing little about the basic features of species. The term species was just used as a term for a sort or kind of an organism, until in 1686, when John Ray introduced biological concept of species, in which he stated that species are distinguished by always producing the same species. But it is important to understand that his concept was fixed and permanent. That means that he was not able to discuss how these species evolved. Though during 18th and 19th centuries, two species concepts were popular. One was Linnaean species concept, another was Darwinian species concept. It is also important that majority of biologists were having knowledge about species before Darwin. And it is pertinent to mention that Darwin was not convinced about the species concept. The Ernest Mayr's contribution was a turning point for the illustration of definition of species, when in 1942 he explained the definition of biological species concept. As I mentioned in the previous slide, that Ernest Mayr's contribution played an important role for understanding species in a better way. So, what is biological species concept as per Ernest Mayr, which he propounded in 1942? According to Ernest Mayr, species is a group of individuals which are potentially or actively able to interbreed with each other to produce fertile offspring and are reproductively isolated from other groups. So this was the major definition which was given by Ernest Mayr. Here you can see one example where you have Eastern Meadowlark and Western Meadowlark. Two species show distinct features and are separated from each other on the basis of reproductive compatibility. So how to distinguish these two species? Biologists have given different criteria, but in a simple way, there are certain songs and behaviors which are enough to separate these two populations, because they are not able to recognize each other as a potential mate. In the previous slide, I have explained it. The definition of biological species concept as given by Ernest Mayr. In this slide, I will explain some of the criteria of biological species concept.
There are three main criteria of species concept. Number one is the group of individuals which form a species act as an interbreeding unit. That means these individuals are able to share gene pool with each other. Second is these individuals which form a species are able to produce fertile offspring. And third is the group of individuals which we recognize as species are reproductively isolated from other groups. So these are the three main criteria on which basis we can define a species. For example, here you have two populations, population A and population B. These two populations are considered as separate species because both of these populations act as interbreeding unit. They produce fertile offspring and are reproductively isolated from other groups. In 1990s, another modified form of biological species came into existence that is known as mate recognition concept, which was given by Patterson. He explained species as a group of individuals which recognize each other as potential mates. Now question arises whether biological species concept is valid for explaining all the living organisms which are present on Earth. The answer is no, because there are different problems related to biological species concept. Number one, this concept is not valid on asexually reproducing organisms. For example, biological species concept is not applicable on bacteria. Second is reproductive isolation is often incomplete because it is a slow process and it takes long duration of time, and sometimes this isolation is incomplete. So as per biological species concept, reproductive isolation should be complete to recognize a particular population as a separate species. So again, this is shortcoming of biological species concept to be used in a wider sense. Hybridization is common among many groups of animals like waterfowl, terrestrial plants, freshwater species. So this also hinders to use biological species concept and separate species on the basis of criteria given by biological species concept. Another important aspect is we have no concrete evidence to assess how individuals of populations have potential to interbreed. So that is another shortcoming which it is pertinent to mention that biological species concept is not the only species concept which explains species in a better way. There are at least 26 species concepts which have been elaborated in the last 100 years. The question arises why there are so many interpretations. The reason being that different biologists or taxonomists use different criteria for the explanation of a particular species concept. That's why there are so many interpretations. Also, species is a dynamic entity. The features which are present in species differ from one geographical region to another geographical region. So that's why there are many interpretations of species. In recent times, biologists have identified a problem in species definition that is known as species problem. The species problem is the long-standing failure of biologists to agree on how we should identify species and how we should define the word species. In conclusion, we can say biological species concept is an accepted model, but needs amendment to make it more holistic.